Excuse me.
Yes, ma'am.
I have a question. Wouldn't it have seemed better and have worked out better if you two had decided to work with Jim and Todd and going down there together, putting up a united front? Did you represent the city of Cumming or the county of Forsyth? And your
you all both had relations with the city,
right?
Yes.
To me, it's a conflict of interest that you're even dealing with the city. The one has the restaurant, the other has the restaurant.
Let me make sure a question about.
I would just like
to. Let me make sure a question first. Commissioner Levent and Commissioner Boff did not ask us to go with Mr. Murphy. Asked us if we'd like to come down after. We had no idea until Saturday before the meeting.
And you're not mad enough to say, hey, Jim, hey, Todd.
You never told us.
I didn't know. I didn't know they were going.
You never told those guys you were going. You were the commission. You never told them until you got back.
Tell
that's really good. That's really good. First thing you've got to learn to do is communicate with your boss.
They didn't tell us?
Not with the mayor.
We
communicate with the mayor, talk to the men on the board.
They didn't ask us to go with them.
Well, no, why'd you ask them?
What was the first step?
No, I didn't ask the mayor.
That's what I was told.
Mr. Turner. Brian
Tam asked the mayor.
Because Mr. Turner asked the mayor. But
one of our state delegation called the mayor and asked him to meet us there.
Yes.
Do you think you
one last thing, do, one last thing.
Let me
I'll just
say one thing up and sit here for an hour and 31 minutes like everybody else. And I think that you and Bobby Amos should recuse yourself in these negotiations.
Okay. Well, you're entitled to your opinion, and I'll just refer you to my voting record for 8 years.
I'm good. Well, I just, you know.
Voting record is what it
is. People are wary of politicians that you don't know. And no matter what level.
Josh is the mayor's transit,
right? Yeah, right. And you're in, you know, with your restaurant and that the mayor owns and whatever, you know, you can't say no to them. So, and like you mentioned, as far as Amos' family, they own, you know, Boo's the property in the county, so it's understandable why you would be sticking up close to the city.
Adoption of the agenda. Are there any modifications to the agenda?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. With respect to public hearing number one, I would propose that we have the public hearing and postpone the vote 2 weeks until the April 19th meeting.
Second.
I have some discussion. Can you tell me what that would benefit?
This item is on the work session for this Tuesday, April the 10th, and I'm optimistic and hopeful that we are going to be able to come to some sort of solution.
By this item, you mean discussion of the water contract?
Water contract, yes, sir.
Councilor? Sir, if this were to fail, if the motion were to fail, does that then carry to the next meeting?
The motion that's currently been made by Commissioner Tam, no, that would act as a defeat. That would be a technical motion.
Thank you.
I think more he was probably trying to come up with an answer if we actually voted on the item today and it was a 2-2 vote. Not postponing it, just for an item, then we roll to the next.
The substantive item of the actual contract itself, if that is a 2-2 vote, that would work as an automatic continuance until the next time the tie could be broken. Chairman Boff, do you understand? I think what Commissioner Lamb was asking is a different question with respect. I thought what you were asking was with respect to what Commissioner Tam's motion was.
Okay. I'm sort of digesting that.
Sorry.
So if we vote on this 2-2, this the motion to postpone and will delay, or will not delay, it will be something we will have to decide tonight or vote on tonight on the substantive issue. But if the substantive issue is 2-2, then it acts as a postponement, so to speak, anyway.
Perfect.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Is there any more discussion? If not, please vote on the motion. All those in favor, vote. And that passes unanimously, with Commissioner Bell being absent. Announcements and reports. I have one. Does anyone else have one? I was asked by Commissioner Bell to read this statement. So where it says I, and here it means Commissioner Bell, not me personally. On this evening's agenda is a public hearing regarding whether to approve a 6-month extension to the raw and finished water contracts between the city of Cumming and the county. When this extension was originally introduced, I was a proponent of the extension and believed it was in the best interest of the county to delay finalizing until October. However, I am now of the opinion that a resolution with respect to both agreements is very close and an extension is no longer necessary. Therefore, I decided not to return early from this trip, he's on vacation, for the sole purpose of voting on an extension agreement that I no longer support. My plan instead is to devote my time and energy to ensuring that the raw and finished water agreements are fully negotiated and approved by the deadline in May, and otherwise to ensure that the best interests of the citizens of the county are protected. That's my announcement. There's no further announcements. I think it's time for public comments.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. We would like to take a moment to review the meeting procedures. Please silence all cell phones and electronic devices. Please refrain from disrupting the meeting to general outburst applause or comments. All comments shall be directed to the entire board and not to a particular commissioner. If you have documents for the commissioners, please provide those to the clerk. If fewer than 7 copies are submitted, only 1 copy will be retained by the clerk as part of the permanent record. Those who wish to speak must sign up by completing a public comment or public hearing form available just outside this room. Information regarding specific requirements to address the board is listed at the podium. Please state that information prior to speaking. Per the county's broadcast policy, the county is not responsible for statements made during public meetings and does not warrant the accuracy of such statements. The public comments portion of the meeting is intended to allow speakers to make a verbal presentation to the board. The number of speakers is limited to 10. Speakers are selected on a first-come basis and will be heard in the order in which they signed up, with the exception that Forsyth County residents will be heard first, with non-county residents to follow until the allotted time has expired. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. The public comments portion is limited to 30 minutes. With respect to the public hearings portion of the meeting, each side, those in opposition and those in support, are allotted 10 minutes to speak. Each speaker is limited to 3 minutes. We have 2 public comment speakers signed up this evening. Our first speaker is Dr. Joe Moses.
Thank you. My name is Joe Moses. I live here in South County. I have no financial interest in the topic on which I'll be speaking, and I'm speaking for no one except myself. With all due apologies to my friend, South County Attorney Mr. Ken Jarrard, for giving him no prior notice of the message to be delivered by Attorney Frank Jenkins tonight, I hope that he will understand. Mr. Jenkins has practiced government law for over 25 years. In his practice, he has handled it in excess of 100 litigation cases concerning local government issues, including suits involving water use. Mr. Jenkins has been involved in the preparation and drafting of zoning and development law at both the state and local level. Among his many accomplishments is that he was selected to serve 2 terms as chairman of the DeKalb County Ethics Board. It's my distinct pleasure to introduce Mr. Frank Jenkins.
Mr. Chairman, members of the commission, I'm here to, in fairness to the commission, to advise of our contention that there is a conflict of interest among your commissioners in voting on the water contract, that either the extension or the water contract itself. That is that Mr. or Commissioner Pete Amos, who owns a water company that buys water from the county and serves as one of his businesses in the county, a water contract between the city and the county would directly affect his business and his business interests.
Mr. Chairman, I object, sir. They're not to address a commissioner by name, and they know that.
That is true. So noted. Please continue to try not to refer to any commissioner by name.
Well, that's the, that is my contention, is that there is a conflict of interest. We know from the Supreme Court cases that a private citizen of a county has a right to contest a vote of a commission in which any commissioner has a conflict of interest. And a conflict of interest, the Supreme Court tells us, arises when there is a business interest by any member of the commission which is affected directly by the matters that come before the commission, and if there's a vote, or even if there's an intent to influence the vote. And we wish to tell the commission in advance of our intent. We have a right to sue, which we intend to do if necessary. And the courts have repeatedly, I will say, reversed or nullified any decision which any member of the commission has with a conflict of interest is voted.
Thank you.
Our next speaker.
And excuse me, in this case, can you have a moment to do it?
I'll say
it doesn't feel right. All right. Thank you, Jody.
Mr. Chair, since my name is mentioned by someone in the audience, I'd like to make a statement this time. I'm aware that certain members of the community have raised concerns with my participation in the city water contract. As I understand it, these concerns are mainly due to my ownership of a company that purchases water from the county. The fact is, my company buys water from both the county and the city, and through its purchases, I do not purchase much more water from the county. And my company is simply a water customer, same as any other water customer in the county. My company gets no special treatment in these purchases. Because my company is just a water customer, I do not believe I have a conflict of interest in the water issue. I know I can make a decision regarding the city-county water contracts that is in the best interest of all my constituents and the county. So therefore, I will not accuse myself of any vote. I plan to represent my district as well as any water contracts negotiated at this time. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, finished the public comments. Public hearings, extension of the raw water intervention contract is postponed.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, sir.
My motion was to postpone the vote, however, to move forward with the public hearing.
Thank you. The vote will be postponed. The public hearing is now.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, thank you. Public hearing number one is an extension of the raw and finished water contracts between the city of Cumming and Forsyth County. This is based upon the Board of Commissioners' rules that state that if a matter is on an intergovernmental agreement that's taken and does not secure a 4/5 vote, that it will then be sent to a public hearing. After public hearing, a simple majority can adopt whatever the item or whatever the intergovernmental agreement was. In this situation, it was an IGA to extend both the raw and finished water contracts until October 31st of this year. It did not secure a 4/5, therefore after this public hearing, we would take it to vote, although that will not happen this evening. We will simply have a public hearing per our rule. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you. Do I hear a motion to open the public hearing?
So moved. Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no discussion on the motion, that passes 4-0 with Commissioner Bell being absent. And we're open for speak in opposition to a postponement of the water contract?
Mr. Chairman, just for purposes of clarification, and again, postponement may be the right word, but it would be, I think, an extension of the water contract.
Yes, let me be clear about that, because I wasn't. What I should have said is, anyone first wish to speak in favor of a decision to ask for an extension about the water contract? And I don't see anybody. And so now we are at, does anyone wish to speak in opposition to a vote to ask for an extension of the water contract? Speaker.
Once again, I'm Joe Moses, representing myself, not speaking for anybody else. I heard what was said by one of the commissioners about this justification as to being a customer. But not only is he a customer, he resells the water to individuals. So that makes it completely different than just being a customer. So y'all need to take that under advisement when you're making your decisions on whether to recuse yourself, because what the argument that was given is just flat out wrong and will not stand up in court. Thank you.
Okay, this is the time to adopt the agenda. Are there any changes to the agenda?
Item number six.
Yes.
I would like to request, if I can get a second, to call a special call meeting Thursday morning. We need just about another day to get this tidied up. I think we're 98% home.
I think so too, and I'll second that. Only I'd like to see it Thursday afternoon.
Let me check.
We can do that. We have a finance committee meeting?
Yeah,
this Thursday.
We get 3 o'clock.
We do, sir.
We could do this 1:30 or 2. I'll move the finance meeting.
I have a transportation and air quality committee meeting.
That's at 10.
At 10 a.m. What time are you calling for? 2?
I was going to say 2 real time. We can move the finance to 4.
We can. We have to do it pretty quickly. It's been advertised.
No. Can we just meet at 2?
Then we meet at 4.
Thursday at 2?
Let's meet at 2, okay. And if we're not done, we'll adjourn recess to go into finance and come back out.
Okay.
We can do that, right?
And then we can recess finance.
Okay. Yes.
And come back to work session and go back to finance.
Still all kinds of recess. It's my favorite part.
I'm up for recess.
I'm going to be back here by 2.
You can give me a proxy out there.
Thank you. Oh, you go downtown?
No.
Oh. I'll just have to be back here by 2, if that's what we decide to do. So we have.
The motion is to postpone and call for a special call work session on Thursday, 2 p.m.
April 12th.
Regarding water.
Item number six. And do we want to put item number, whatever it was, the other one? Seven, perhaps, and what is the one for first?
That's not for next time.
Oh, okay.
So why don't we,
I don't know why we can't go forward with number 7 today.
Let's just take number 6, number right now.
Okay, we have a motion and a second.
Mr. Chairman, before we take a vote, I'll give my written statement into record.
Yes, sir.
This is a statement to Pete Amos on record with respect to the city county water contracts. I have given the allegations I have with respect to the city water. I have given the allegations that I have a conflict of interest, considerable thought since it was discussed last Thursday night. While I maintain my position that I do not have a conflict of interest, I believe the water contract issue is too important an issue to leave this outcome to chance, or for me to take an official action on the contract and then find the county on the other side of the lawsuit, the needless lawsuit, that seems to undo the county's decision. Therefore, in an effort to ensure that I have nothing, I've done everything within my power to provide the public confidence that I can legitimately take action on these very important issues. I wish to announce that in the next couple of days, I will deliver to the Forsyth County Board of Ethics a request for an advisory opinion. The question is the Board of Ethics to issue a determination as to whether a conflict of interest either disqualifies me for the existing water contract issue. And until the Board of Ethics reaches a decision, I will conditionally and temporarily recuse myself from taking any action on the water contracts. When the Board of Ethics renders an advisory opinion, I will then conduct myself in a manner consistent with this decision. It's my statement that I will recuse myself on any vote on water today.
Thank you.
Any vote on postponing the meeting, the special call meeting?
In light of that, I would request you not do that.
Okay, that's right.
Thank you.
So we have a motion.
Okay, we have a motion on the table and a second to postpone this item to a special called work and create or have an advertised a special called work session for 2 p.m. this Thursday, in which this will be then discussed. And we have a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion on this item? If not, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed, like sign. There are none. With Commissioner Amos conditionally recusing himself, and I should have said at the outset, all commissioners are here today. Continuing on changes to the agenda, which I think we had started talking about item number 7.
I'd like to move that to Thursday as well. After item number 6.
Is that a second?
Yes, second.
We have a motion and a second.
Mr. Chairman, up before I will recuse myself from any vote.
We have a motion and a second. Is there any further discussion? To postpone this item now and move it to the work session on Thursday. That's the motion as I understand it. Special call work session. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Aye. That passes 3-1 with Commissioner Amos conditionally recusing himself on water discussion.